All right, so now that y'all got that little slow-mo in the beginning, hello, what is up? It's your girl Ashika Lee here back at it with another video. And at first, what you guys saw me do was pour some hot boiling water into this pan, and then I just used some regular running hot water from the pipe. So the hair that I'm using in this video, it is from You Pretty. I'm showing you guys the lace. It's super thin, transparent 613. Pre-made 16 inch bob unit, and I'm using these three colors here. I'm really just using like a mixture of everything because I knew I wanted to do red, but I didn't want it to look completely red. Like, I wanted some mahogany, I wanted to be a bit deep, but I still wanted it to be vibrant. So I went in with all different types of measurements of each colors, and I am just adding it to the pan, mixing it up with my coloring brush. And what I like to do, I just like to like tap some of the water out into the sink to see if it's the color that I wanted, and it was. So now I'm just going to dip the ends first just to see how the color is turning out. So one thing that I am scared about with coloring and like doing like the watercolor method with blonde hair, when you are doing like pigmented colors like red, the lace sometimes does tint. So what you guys see me doing, I was actually testing to see if the lace will tint or not. Now you can use that freeze spray method by spraying the lace and then dipping it so that the knots won't get stained, but that does not prevent the lace from actually tinting. So I poured out that water and then I redid it. I think I dipped the hair about 4 or 3 times just because I really wanted it pigmented and I wanted all of the hairs to be equally saturated with the color. So I'm going in with that copper brown shade and it's pretty much done. Y'all, I was just using whatever color I had left. I did not feel like running to the hair store and buying more color. So this is pretty much, you know, using leftovers from what I had. So again, just mixing it up and then going back in. So as you guys can see, the bottom of the hair was like that red and the top was that pink. And I was trying to get rid of that. And so what I did was I did end up dipping the whole lace into it. But what I did was just leave the actual lace out of the water and just made sure that the hairline and the roots of the hair was actually saturated in the water. And I left it in there for some time, I think about 2 minutes, and then I took it out to see how it would look. And y'all, I loved the color. I loved it. But then I felt like the red was just a little bit too bright, and maybe it looked a little bit like kind of like pinky, more so red. So I believe I dipped it again, and just so that it can have a bit more of that deeper color. So this is me refilling the water again and just using whatever dye that I have left out of them bottles, you know, scraping up the little bits and pieces. And this time I used less water and more dye so that the color could be deeper. And then just went in and mixed it again. And then I did the same thing, dipped the hair and allowed it to sit for a minute or so. And as you guys can see, the color is definitely deeper, which I wanted from the beginning. So love the way that the color turned out. Of course, not gonna lie, I was scared because it's not like an actual red color. It was actually like a reddish, burgundy-ish, pinkish color. And you guys will see that later on. So I allowed the hair to sit in the pan for about 2 minutes, and then I am just dipping it, making sure that the hair gets all of the pigment that is in the water. And again, you guys, if you are interested in purchasing this hair, you can check the description box down below. This hair is from You Pretty, and yeah, I gave you guys the rundown about the measurements and about it being 16 inches and all of that before, but you guys can check the description box down below if you're interested in purchasing, or if you just wanted more into detail looking at the sales and discounts that they have, and all of that information will be down there. So make sure you guys go check their site out. Their hair is very affordable, and the hair was super soft, and the lace was so thick. Thin and it melted perfectly. You guys will see once I install it. But yeah, so what you guys see me doing now is just shampooing the hair. I did only one shampoo of the hair because I mean, I'm dipping it into water, so I don't know. I felt like it wasn't really necessary. So it wasn't really that much color residue coming off. And then I went in with some conditioner. Now, this is a Tresemme conditioner, and I didn't let it sit. I just ran it through the hair and then washed it out. And I also went and blow dried it and styled it. And now we are going to install the wig. So at this point, you guys, I was actually really scared and I was in a rush. So y'all know how I get when I'm in a rush. I do everything all over the place, but we got it done. So another thing, you guys, I know I look probably really yellow. I tried to fix the saturation and exposure and color and all of that. It was just the edit on my camera. I fixed it later down the line when I did my makeup, but for now you're just gonna have to deal with the vibrance of the hair and my skin and all of that stuff. It'll get better once I noticed that I changed it, but yeah, so ignore that. So what you guys see me doing is just, what you guys see me doing is adding the foundation to the lace, and I also added only 2 coats of the Bold Hold Lace Glue. So while I was doing that, I just decided to go ahead and do my eyebrows, and I'm using the ColourPop brow pencil in the shade Black and Brown. I will also leave all the makeup products that I use in the video in the description box below, because I'm pretty sure I'll forget the name of something, or I just forget to name what I used. So everything will be down there. But I just went ahead, filled in my brows. Didn't need to do much because I got them done. And now I'm just going in with the second layer of the Bold Hold Active. Guys, this is multitasking at its finest. Like, I was doing about 50 things at once, okay? I was jumping back from the brows to the face primer. This is the Too Faced face primer, to the illuminator, to the wig. Yes, y'all, I was in a rush, okay? So now I am laying the frontal into the glue, pressing it down with my fingers and my hand, because once you add pressure, everything is pretty much set. So I really was just making sure that everything was good. But as you guys can see, like right in the middle of my head, it's like it just wasn't laying properly. So I just had to stretch the unit across my forehead a bit more so that everything can lay flat and I won't have any lumps in my hair. Well, in the lace. So once that's on, I'm just going in, pressing everything in and cutting off those excess air tabs. And I will cut all of it off once I'm done and okay with where it is. So now I'm going in with the eyebrow razor. And you guys know I prefer to use this over a scissors anytime, any day. It just makes the job easier. Like, cutting that lace off in that zigzag motion just comes so naturally and so much easier when you use the eyebrow razor. There are plenty other techniques that you can do, but this is just what I prefer. And once you cut the lace off, you just want to make sure that you are still pressing the lace into your skin as well. And yeah. So I realized that after all of that, I felt like the wig just still wasn't sitting right on my head. So I pulled it forward and then added some more glue to the areas that I missed or just that wasn't like sticking. And once it dried, I just went in and pressed everything in. And the lace was looking real good, y'all. This thing was melted. Good, good, good. And I definitely had some extra lace left over on my ear pieces. So I just went in with some scissors and cut all of that off. And then just went in and tacked down the lace. And then onto the baby hairs. I didn't want to do too much because, I don't know, for some reason, I feel like baby hair on colored hair looks a bit trash. I don't want to say trashy, but it just doesn't look realistic. Everybody knows it's not yours anyway, so you might as well try to make it look as realistic as possible. So I just like to do a few, like 3-4, not that much. And yeah, so I just went in with some Got to Be Glue, cut the baby hair the shortest that I wanted it. And I cannot talk. And I am just using my brush that I got from the hair store. And while all of that is still melting into my skin, I'm going in to tie it down. And then I'm going to jump onto the makeup portion. So as you guys can see, that edit is off and I'm looking like my regular skin complexion right now. And I'm just going in with the Juvia's Place foundation, mixed it with the Fit Me Matte and Poreless. And I got my perfect shades. The shade names will be down in the description box below as well. And then for concealer, I went in with the Too Faced concealer along with the Tarte on top. And then for my brows, I was looking at them and I'm like, wait, I have red hair. And this black eyebrow is just like not doing it for me. So I just went in with some red eyeshadow and I just applied it to my brows as well. Just to give it like a hint of red, which I felt like came out pretty well and added some flavor to the look. So I went in with the same Morphe sponge to blend out my concealer, and then I went in and set it with the Milk setting powder. And this is like my favorite setting powder so far. And now for contour, I just went in with powder contour, didn't feel like doing the whole cream and then setting it. So I'm using my Oldie But Goodie BH Cosmetics contour palette. Very good for beginners because it has a range of colors. And then I'm going in with the Milani blush. This blush wasn't really showing up because it was super like light. So it is there, but it's not completely there. And then for highlight, I'm using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kit. You guys know this is one of my favorite highlighter palettes ever. And it's at my face using the Morphe Continuous Setting Mist. So now for eyes, I just went in with the L'Oreal Infallible Mascara. The wand is super small, so I know it's going to get on all of my hairs. And then I'm just applying my lashes that I got from Amazon. And for lips, I'm just using a brown lip liner and then going in with the Pixi Lip Injection Lip Plumper Lip Gloss. And back to the hair. So pretty much our eyes and our face is done. And I didn't feel like going in with a hot comb, so what I did was just use free spray and just kind of press the hair into the part that I would like it to be, and went in with some concealer to make my part look a bit more realistic. As you guys can see, it definitely does. And then I just went in with a wide teeth comb and I'm just combing out all of the curls so that everything can look really nice. And you guys, this is pretty much the completed look. I love the way the curls came out. This is like definitely a look right here, okay? And I just went in to fix that line where my scarf was that I missed applying makeup completely. So I hope you all enjoyed this look. If you did, you know what to do. Give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe to your girl's channel. Thank you guys so much for watching. I absolutely love this color. Leave a comment down below if you guys like this color as well. And before we go, today's motivational quote is, "For I know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future." And that is a word, okay? With that being said, I will see you loves in my next one. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye.